Right. Name an animal that will attack.
Dog.
I think extra point to Ellen. I mean, he was fast, you know.
Yeah.
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 Anybody,
didn't realize
what do you think, audience?
Fire.
Extra point to Ellen?
Yeah.
Yeah. Ready? Name an animal.
Horse.
Name an animal that will attack anything red.
Bull.
Why do you think that?
Because I've seen clips of those dreadful matadors, where they wave the red and then the bull.
Yeah, it's the movement, not the colour, that is.
Really?
Yes, darling, oh. I know. They're not bothered by any particular colour. Just gets irritated by the cloth waving.
It would be a nightmare in a curtain shop, wouldn't it?
Yes.
I'm surprised that's not a saying, isn't it? Like a bull in a curtain shop.
The one animal which does see red in both senses is the tiny little robin. They are incredibly aggressive. 10% of... huge. They're huge as well. 10% of robin deaths are due to fractured skulls from altercations with other robins.
Oh. I thought it was when they were stapled to Christmas cards.
Yeah. So there was some experiments done by a man called David Lack in 1943, and he showed that robin would attack a stuffed robin placed in its territory.
Good to know that he was helping with the war effort.
Maybe he was trying to train them up. Secret weapon.
But the robin attacked and the head came off the stuffed robin and the robin carried on. And he began to wonder how little stuffed robin you would need in order to prompt this particular response. So he mounted various body parts on trees and so on. And he found as long as red feathers were present, the robin would attack. A headless, wingless, tailless, legless, bodiless bundle of red feathers was still a legitimate wow. target as far as a robin was concerned. In fact, the robin would sometimes attack a tomato left on the bed.
Except the Nazis were terrified, weren't they?
I know.
So robins can't look in mirrors then, clearly, because it'll just set themselves off.
It'll set themselves off.
Or, yeah. Oh, well, come on then, come on in, let's have a go.
Exactly yeah. that. And you'd think the red breast is something to attract.
Yeah.
Before mating, it isn't that at all. It's a warning to stay away. So a robin's breast gets bigger and redder with each year. So the bigger and redder the breast, the more fights it's had. And you don't want to... It's like working. It's like working with children.
You just said big and red and breast together, yeah. and it'll set me off.
And bigger every year.
Bigger every year. Clear around the pool. Look at that big red breast, way.
Do you think that robins come back to your garden year after year?
Yes.
Oh yes, they love it.
No.
It's a different one?
Well, they don't last very long, so only 25% of newborns get through the very first year. Less than 1% make it to the age of 5. The lifespan's about 1.1 years for a robin, so they don't actually live.
I thought it was the same robins coming back to my garden, fat robin and thin robin.
Yeah, no, not a thing, I'm afraid. Well, no, probably the robin you know is dead. I should have put that more gently.
So's the other one.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
Jesus
Happy
Christ.
Christmas.
Jesus Christ. She's really quite harsh there. No, it's dead, Susan.
That's right. I was a terrible parent. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.